My trip started in the far east of Russia, in Vladivostok, 3,900 kilometers to the Lake Baikal and the Mongolian border. Most interesting to me was a railway station in Vladivostok, destination or starting point of the Trans-Siberian Railway. It's located directly at the harbor, and from there you can reach the ferries to Japan or Korea by walking. Two days after my arrival, also the Land Cruiser left the customs area of the harbor. Everything is perfect. The last documents were stamped soon and the long journey could start. The friendly cargo agents showed me still the Russian sign for diesel at the gas station before my departure. Here I had already driven 600 kilometers and from Chita to the Mongolian border it must be another 800 kilometers. This is how one imagines Siberia. Wide open spaces, forests, slightly hilly country and now and then small villages. I had to clean the windscreen of the car every hour in this area. Luckily, I had enough water with me. Most Russian highways are very good. Many were recently newly built. After 800 kilometers, Khabarovsk, the first big city north of Vladivostok. Where the highways are not yet finished, a lot of road construction is going on. Sometimes, however, the construction sites have a length of 20, 30 or 40 kilometers. Then finally Ulan-Ude, on the other side of the Lake Baikal, opposite Irkutsk. Here is the largest portrait bust in the world, Lenin. They left the monument standing after 1990, because you never know what will happen. One complete car wash, please, before I drive in the direction of the Mongolian border on different roads. The border crossings on the road followed the same pattern everywhere. There was an entrance area with license plate registration, main area with passport, customs and luggage control, and then a last check before leaving the border area if you have received all the necessary stamps. Unfortunately, outside the EU, this was done separately for each country, means twice at one border. There were no joint controls of both countries, and so I planned a full day for each border crossing.